Here's your typical game dev workflow. You make a change, run the game, and test. It's not quite right. So you stop the game, make a change, run the game, and so on. It may only take 10 seconds each time, but you'll do this tens of thousands of times while making your game, which adds up to hours of lost time. There's a better way, and it only takes 3 clicks. You see the debug menu, open it and check the two synchronize options. They make Godot load changes instantly while the game's running. It's also called hot reloading. Let's see it in action. You can see some tiles missing at the bottom of this level. So what do? Well, we add them. And as soon as you draw them in the editor, they appear in the running game. I'm going to add some water. Maybe I want a mountain here in the middle. Or maybe not. I'll just undo. Alright, that's synchronizing the scene changes for you. Now, I have another issue with the code. My character can fly like that, but if I release the stick, it falls, but really, really slowly. And I don't want that to happen. So what do? I go to the code tab, and the issue I have here has to do with this line. It should really be in an else block. So I move it down, I nest it in a conditional block, save, and now, when I go back to my game and play, the character falls smoothly with nice curves. And that's synchronizing the script changes. Mind that, as impressive as this feature is, it has some limitations. As it preserves your running game, changing the init already functions won't apply to existing nodes. Makes sense because they are already in the game. If you want to learn to code by making games, we're on Kickstarter until October 31 to create an in-depth course for absolute beginners. Click the link in the description to get all the details. Be creative, have fun, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.